Hey guys, welcome to the Great Outdoors RV. My name is Mate, and today I'm going to show you how to work the Wi-Fi system in a Rockwood. So the Wi-Fi extender is really cool because it will extend, instead of your antenna being this big, you have a big antenna on top of your roof that can get a lot better signal. So if there's a Starbucks or Xfinity or something like that down the road, you can connect to it. And I want to show you how that works. So right now, as you can see, if I go to my, and I'll go to my phone here, if I go to my Wi-Fi and it's trying to connect, I might have one bar if I'm lucky right there, but really I'm not going to have enough of a signal to make this work. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit this Wi-Fi button. So I'm going to go ahead and turn this on. Now that is just like a router. So just like a router at home, it takes a minute or two for it to boot up. So I'll let you guys kind of have a real-time scenario of how long this takes to boot up. You can of course fast forward for probably about a minute or so and go from there. Just keep the camera going and we'll just wait. Hey Colleen.
Hi.
Hey Tara. Anybody know any good jokes? That's internet friendly.
Appropriate.
All right, so we're still waiting for this to connect. Might be another second or two, minute or two. Hey, while we're waiting, I wanted to tell you a great place that I just got back from camping at is Kurt Gowdy up in Wyoming. It's about 20 minutes west of Cheyenne. It's about an hour and a half from Greeley here. And it was awesome. They have campsites that you could reserve. They have ones that had full hookups. They also had places that you didn't have to reserve, that you could just show up and hope that there was a spot. They had spots for just tents, spots for RVs and tents, spots for just RVs. You could kayak there. They had about 35 miles worth of bike trails and hiking trails. They have a really cool place that you should check out called Hidden Falls if you get a chance. Hey, and this just appeared. So as you can see, I have something on my phone that says WiFiRanger Sky whatever, and it just happens to match what this says on this little sticker here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that, and it's asking for a password. The password on this one, and it'll be right on your sticker, is change me now 8914. Yours will be of course slightly different than that, and I'll go ahead and connect to that. So I hit connect. Oh, let me try it one more time. Change, share password, me now 8914. All right, and connect. Oh, all of a sudden it's good to go. Now you can hit this go to Wi-Fi settings, but you see that it says internet may not be available. That's because you still need to open up a browser and tell the router which Wi-Fis are okay to hook up to and not. So what I'm going to do now is I am going to go to my Chrome browser on my phone, and I'm going to type in this address right here. So this address here is 10.189.14.1:8080. So I just opened up an internet browser and typed that in right there. I'm going to hit go. And what this is bringing up is a list of all the Wi-Fis that are available. And as you can see, there are a lot more Wi-Fis available now that we have that big antenna. So the one that says open, of course, that doesn't require a password. So if I clicked on that one, that would automatically connect me to Xfinity Wi-Fi. Or if there was a Starbucks or something like that in here, you would do that. Or if you know the password to say, like, let's say the pizza joint down the street has a Wi-Fi, but it's security protected, you could click on that and then entering the password to the pizza place, and then you are up and running, ready to do Wi-Fi. Now this will draw your battery down because it is a power boosted Wi-Fi, so make sure you turn that off after you're done using it so that you don't drain your battery. Have a great day. Thanks. Bye.